हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज रेबेका सुल्ताना, सीनियर टीचर इंग्लिश, बनानी विद्यानिकेतन स्कूल एंड कॉलेज। होप यू आर ओयल। वेलकम टू माय इंग्लिश क्लास। आर्ली, बिफोर द यूजुअल टाइम्स। आउटसाइड, द आउटर साइड और सरफेस ऑफ समथिंग। पुट, टू कीप और टू प्लेस समथिंग समवेयर। फील, to make something full or to become full. Smell, the ability to sense things with nose. Feel, to experience something physically or mentally. Warm, comfortable temperature or fairly high temperature between cool and hot. Fresh, made obtained or experienced recently and still not changed. Visually, in respect of vision or concerned with seeing or sight. Impaired, damaged or disabled. Visually impaired, disabled in respect of vision. Unable, not having the ability to do something. Experience, the process of gaining knowledge or skill over a period of time through seeing and doing things. Braille, a form of script for blind people where raised dots represent letters and numerals. Raised, higher than surrounding area or surface. Dot, a small round mark or spot. Script, a written text of a play, film, talk, etc. Hope, to want something and to consider it possible. University, the highest level of educational institution. Information, facts or details about somebody or something. Amazing, very surprising. Dear students, have a look at this picture. What can you see? Flowers, cuckoo, green leaves on trees, girls are enjoying themselves decorating with flowers. Which season is this? You are right, spring season. How is this picture? Beautiful, isn't it? How do you feel in this season? How is your life? I think you feel life is beautiful like me. Life is beautiful in all seasons, but in spring we especially feel it very much. We feel life is beautiful because we can see all the beauty of nature, like flower, trees, blue sky, singing birds, etc. But how do you feel if your eyes is tied with a piece of cloth or handkerchief? Everything is dark in front of you, isn't it? You will not see this beauty of nature. Do you know there are some people who cannot see this beauty of nature? They cannot see the colorful things of this world. Everything is dark to them. They have problems in eyesight. We call them visually impaired person. We don't behave rudely and laugh at them. We should help them so that they can make their life beautiful. Today, we will learn a story about a visually impaired girl. Everything is dark to her, but life is beautiful to her. Let's learn how life is beautiful to a visually impaired girl. Our today's topic is Life is Beautiful. Unit 20. Lesson 1 to 6, page 78 to 80. Students, open at page 78. It's a beautiful spring day. Maria gets up early in the morning. She feels happy. So what can we know from here? We know that Maria is an early riser. She knows that it's a nice day because she puts her hand on the glass of the window. It is very warm. She opens the window and the singing of the birds fills the room. She can smell the flowers outside her room. They smell sweet and fresh. After Maria gets dressed and has her breakfast, she puts her books in her bag. She is ready for school. Maria is a lot like any other students in her neighborhood. She goes to school and likes to be with her friends. That means Maria is a student like other students in her neighborhood. But Maria cannot see the beautiful spring day. She cannot see the flowers, the blue sky, or the singing birds. She cannot see the new green leaves on the trees. She cannot see these because she is visually impaired. She has been unable to see since she was born. Students, now open at page 79. But Maria is happy. She goes to school every day. She can learn the information because she reads Braille. Braille is a script that uses raised dots. Each letter is made from dots. People move their fingers across the raised dots to read. Maria learned to read Braille as a young child. Her books at school are in Braille. She enjoys reading poems and history. Maria's teacher says she is a good learner. Now, let's learn something about Louis Braille. He was born on 4 January 1809 and died on 6 January 1852. Louis Braille was a blind French teacher and he was famous because he invented the Braille system. When he was 3 years old, he was playing with an awl in his father's craft. An awl is a small pointed tool used for piercing holes, specially in leather. He started to run with the awl in his hand and he fell to the ground. So he nailed the awl in his left eye. That infection damaged his right eye too. And in that moment, Louis Braille became blind. After becoming blind, he wanted a way to read. He invented a system of raised dots that could be read using the fingers. Today, this method is still used by people who are blind. We call this method Braille. Now, let's see how a blind person read and write by using Braille.
Read it for us.
Hi, Brian. Mommy loves you so much. I am so proud of you. Love, Mommy.
students, now open at page 80. Maria hopes to go to university one day. Her teachers think that she can. Maria wants to set up a school of her own so that she can teach visually impaired children. Before this, Maria wants to be a writer. She wants to write a book about her feelings and experiences. She wants to show other impaired people that they can do amazing things in their lives. Now, I will give you some classwork. Number 1. Match the words of column A with their meaning that is mentioned in column B. Column A, number A, warm. Number B, smell. Number C, unable. Number D, visually impaired. Number E, braille. Column B. Number 1. A form of script for blind people where raised dots represents letters and numerals. Number 2. Comfortable temperature. Number 3. Disabled in respect of vision or sight. Number 4. Not having the ability to do something. Number 5. The ability of sense things with nose. Now match the column A with column B. Number A. Warm. What will be its meaning? Number 2. Comfortable temperature. Number B. Smell. Its meaning? The ability of sense things with nose. It will be number 5. Number C. Unable. What will be its meaning? Number 4. Not having the ability to do something. Number D. Visually impaired. Its meaning, disabled in respect of vision or sight. Number E, braille. Its meaning, number 1, a form of script for blind people where raised dots represents letters and numerals. Now write down it on your khata. I think you have already written your answer. Now check your answer with me. Number A, warm, comfortable temperature. Number B, smell, the ability of sense things with nose. Number C, unable, not having the ability to do something. Number D, visually impaired, disabled in respect of vision or sight. Number E, braille, a form of script for blind people where raised dots represents letters and numerals. Number 2. Write true for correct statement or false for incorrect statement. Number A. The glass of window feels very hot. Is it true or false? It's false because the glass of window feels comfortably hot. So the answer is false. Number B. The day mentioned in the passage is a nice summer day. Is it summer day? No. It is spring day. So the answer is false. Number C. Maria is an early riser. We learn from this passage that Maria gets up early in the morning. So Maria is an early riser. It is true. Number D. She is a special girl. Is it true or false? Yes, it's true. She is a special girl because she needs special help. So the answer is true. Number E. In braille script, words are written in big dots. Is it true? No, it is not true because in braille script, words are written in raised dots. So the answer is false. Number F. Braille is a kind of book. Is it true? Is it a book? No, it is not a book. It is a kind of method. So the answer is false. Number G. Maria wants to be an university teacher. It is not true because Maria wants to be an university student. So the answer is false. Number H. Maria's school will teach children with impaired vision. It is true because Maria wants to set up a school for visually impaired children. So the answer is true. Number 3. Answer the following questions in a sentence or sentences. Number A. How is the day? Answer. The day is a beautiful spring day. Number B. Why does Maria feel happy in the morning? Answer. Maria feels happy in the morning because she knows that it is a nice spring day. Number C. How is the window? Answer. The window is very warm. Number D. How are Maria's books at school? Answer. Maria's books at school are in Braille. Number E. What did Maria learn as a young child? Answer. Maria learned to read Braille as a young child. Number F. What does Maria want to set up? Answer. Maria wants to set up a school for visually impaired children. Number G. What does Maria want to show other visually impaired people? Answer. Maria wants to show other visually impaired people that they can do amazing things in their lives. Now I will give you some homework. Part 1, Lesson 1, 2, 3 and 4. Number 1. Match the words of column A with their meaning that is mentioned in column B. Column A. Number A. Neighborhood. Number B. Unable. Number C. Information. Number D. Learner. Number E. Dot. Number 1. A person who is learning a subject or skill. Number 2. Facts or details about somebody or something. Number 3. A small round mark or spot. Number 4. Near a particular place. Number 5. Not having the ability to do something. Number 2. Write true for correct statement or false for incorrect statement. Number A. Braille is a script only for Maria. Number B. The singing of the birds fills the window. Number C. Maria gets ready for school herself. Number D. She enjoys history only. Number E. Braille is a kind of book. Number F. Though Maria is blind, she is not unhappy. Number G. The method Maria uses for learning is called Braille. Number H. Maria is a brilliant student. Number 3. Answer the following questions in a sentence or sentences. Number A. What is the season in the passage? Number B. How does Maria feel in the morning? Number C. How does Maria know that it's a nice day? Number D. What happens when Maria opens the window? Number E. Why can't Maria see the beautiful things of the spring day like the flowers, the blue sky or the singing birds? Number F. What is Braille? Number G. How can visually impaired people read Braille? Number H. What is the passage about? Part 2, Lesson 5 and 6. Number 1. Match the words of column A with their meaning that is mentioned in column B. Column A. Number A. Hope. Number B. University. Number C. Amazing. Number D. Feeling. Number E. Experience. Number 1. Process of gaining knowledge through seeing and doing things. Number 2. Very surprising. Number 3, the highest level of educational institution. Number 4, to want something and to consider it possible. Number 5, something that one feels through the mind or through the senses. Number 2. Write true for correct statement or false for incorrect statement. Number A. Maria wants to set up a school in future. Number B. Maria's second dream was to be a writer. Number C. Maria will write about her feelings and experiences in her book. Number D. Maria wants to establish a school for normal child. Number E. Maria's teacher's opinion about her is negative. Number F. She wants to write a poem. Number G. Maria wants to be an idol for others. Number H. Maria goes to school irregularly. Number 3. Answer the following questions in a sentence or sentences. Number A. What does Maria hope? Number B. What does Maria's teachers think about her? Number C. Why does Maria want to establish a school? Number D. What does Maria want to be before setting up a school? Number E. What kind of book does Maria want to write? Number F. What does Maria want to prove? Goodbye.